happy Friday, everybody. Mark again here, Weatherman Plus. I got some big updates on what's going on with these big changes about to take place. Matter of fact, you can see what's going on. It's not just our severe weather. It's also in our tropics. Now, real quick, taking care of Hawaii. Still showing you have the best case scenario. This is coming right below you. It is moving west at 16 miles per hour. And you see potentially get some tropical storm force winds on a very far southern side of the far southern island, maybe getting somewhere around 66 miles per hour max winds, sustained winds, potentially right off the coast. This could be lower down because it's so far away from the center. It all depends if it's a northern track or their southern track, but still you can bring up to 60 miles per hour sustained winds for you over there. So just be warned of that. It is a strengthening tropical storm, but you literally have the best case scenario. But this pattern we're going into, still we have that trough coming in, and it's not getting that negative tilt. It's getting a couple upper level lows. You can clearly see this right here. You have a couple upper level lows, and it takes over on the northern side. And that goes up through Canada, becomes one strong system. Now, this is bringing some strong downdrafts. That's bringing us some potential damage and winds, some chances for some large hail, maybe even some very large hail that comes out of that. Plus, we still have this sneaky wave that's pushing through towards the Gulf, and it could get pulled up northerly as it's passing to the west, very weak, but could get pulled up by that trough and potentially head north. Now, so far it's showing maybe late formation at the last minute, right before landfall. More likely will not form up. That's what the trend has been, but still being the very warm waters in the Gulf, we do need to watch that as well. And what's going on for the rest of the hurricane season. So I'm gonna give you all the latest updates in this video. Make sure you do subscribe if you've never been here before. My weather forecasting is all year, along through all seasons. Matter of fact, we have a chance for this cold air to come in with this trough. You're going to be above average. You still got all this heat going in on the eastern side, but on the western side, it's going to be colder. And you have chance, slight chance, small areas that could see some snow already in August. But you can see what your temperatures are as we go in from Friday into Saturday. You get very cool temperatures start moving through, especially in the higher elevations. But as you go all the way into Sunday, and this moves further, it brings even cold air. You even get a chance for down into the 20s in the higher elevations of California, some of Idaho, even some of Nevada, and maybe some of Oregon as well. But this really brings in a nice cool dip for y'all. At the same time, it brings in the very much warm temperatures over here. And this is creating a lot of instability, a lot of cape, a lot of lift for these thunderstorms to grow. And this is what's helping bring in your large hail. Not a lot of strong winds aloft, so it won't be a lot of chances for wind direction change or height with the tornadoes. Could get some speed shear, but that's about it. Maybe a small chance. But you bring in all these very warm temperatures that is supporting these thunderstorms, and that's going for multiple days as well, as it brings the cooler temperatures on the west, and it brings the warmer temperatures towards the eastern side. But you can see literally how it comes in and it brings all these below average temperatures for what you normally get this time of year as you go Friday into Saturday. And we're talking anywhere up to 30, almost 40 degrees below average as that swings through. So when you take a look at the latest hazards, you can see we do have that hazardous heat kicking in. We have our severe weather, but we also have a frost or freeze advisory going on for portions of California, Nevada, even the southern side of Oregon and Idaho and some of Utah. Just some cooler temperatures passing through. So it is a frost or freeze advisory, but at the same time, you got the storm system coming through, bring in some precipitation, and you actually have spots that is going to see some snow over here in August. More snow over here in Canada. That's what the higher amounts you see, up to 10, 11 inches. But this is all 2 to 3 inches. If you back it all the way back, you can see this is 2 to 3 to 4 inches of snowfall in higher elevations, of course. But people are already going to start seeing some flakes of snow going through August. Now, another thing this is going to bring is our severe weather as this trough moves to the east, northeast. And you see it does pull up your dew points as you go Saturday. It gets stronger as you go through Sunday. As that goes really high on that tilt, it gets a lot stronger for Sunday. And this is bringing strong 70s, even 80s almost up to the north central and the upper Midwest. Right there, you might have an 80 on there. See, even getting the 80s up there, but it gets stronger. As you go from Sunday into Monday, look at that. Now you get some strong dew points getting into the 80s up there as well. So this is going to travel. This will help bring particulates in the atmosphere. This is what this is measuring. And when you get enough, when you get into the 70s, it's going to start creating these thunderstorms popping in the atmosphere, especially in the 80s. It's going to be some strong storms start popping up. Now, these storms are going to head to the north, but you're going to get down drafts in the southern side of it. And with this heat coming across is going to bring a lot of instability. Very strong heat going from 80s going into the 90s. Just some very strong temperatures rising up, bringing your instability. So you can see this here on your cape, on your lift. As you go into Sunday, it brings up strong values on your lift all the way into Canada. But watch how strong it gets. First, you get over 6,000 joules. And then as you go from Saturday into Sunday, it gets stronger with all them temperatures. Look at that. Now it's going over 7,000 joules, almost at 8,000. Look at that. Then it goes to 8,000. Then when you go from Sunday into Monday, it grows again with a lot of strong lift in the atmosphere. Now, this will make these storms very robust, and they will go very high in the atmosphere, creating your chance for your large hail. And you can see when you look at your winds aloft, as you go from Friday to Saturday into Sunday, you really don't have any on this system all the way into Monday. Now, Euro is not high resolution, but you can see as you go through, it's showing you're going to get those 40s and 50 miles per hour wind gusts coming on the western side, lower 48 from the first set of systems. I'll show you better information from a high resolution model. But still, you can see as it goes further to the east, even not being a high resolution model, you're not seeing a lot of winds coming out of that. You can see some banding and chances for something to form, but you're not seeing a lot. We will get better information as we get a little bit closer, but clearly it's picking up on energy and strong storms, because look at Canada. It's showing all the damage and winds they're going to get. So as we look a little better with a higher resolution model, you can see with the HRRR, the high resolution rapid refresh, that we do have a lot of strong winds that is coming with the system. So as we look for it, we can see as we go Friday into Saturday, this is bringing 40 in the green, 50 in the yellow, and pockets of 60 miles per hour wind gusts going up through Canada. Then as you go Saturday into Sunday, it grows more, even a little bit all the way to Sunday morning. It grows more of an area where a lot of people are going to be experiencing anywhere from 40 to 50, even pockets of 60 miles per hour wind gusts. At the same time, you can see when you look for your lightning strikes with the Euro. And as we go through Sunday evening, you can see all that banding and damaging winds start sparking up going from North Dakota into Canada mostly. And northern Minnesota needs to watch out for that banding as well as you go into Monday morning. And as you go through Monday, here it comes again, starting to bring some more of that banding pushing to the east. So this is going to bring chances for damaging winds, and it's going to bring chances for large hail. And you can see that in those lightning strikes. That is representative of a lot of lightning strikes bringing the chance for the large hail. So you can see the downdrafts bringing the large hail with it. You see it coming from the northern side as you go through the Monday. So it's just bringing these storms as well. And this is going to be your main threat. Now, just to show you the impacts, you can see for today, you don't have no chances for tornadoes. You have a 5% chance for the winds and a low 5% chance for the chance for hail. And I did show you the winds a little while ago. So here's your cities and states so far at risk for those damaging winds for today. National Weather Service has strong severe storms with severe gusts and possibly some hail are possible across Montana, then into Mountain West and Central Rockies, Southeast Arizona to extreme southwestern New Mexico, and the central and northern high plains. You also can see the transformation for tomorrow, for Saturday. No chances for tornadoes. It's just going to be some chances for wind, a 5%, and a smaller chance for hail. So here's your cities and states at risk for the chance for those damaging winds that I showed you. This is for tomorrow, for Saturday. Now here we are for Sunday. As we move on through, you can see that you got that 15% risk. You see it has moved further to the north as well. So far, here's your cities and states at risk for the severe weather for Sunday. The National Weather Service does have this risk for large hail and damaging wind gusts. And the stronger bands will come through as you go through the afternoon and evening. And finally, here we are for Monday. As it heads up through Canada, it is not going to go past Monday, everybody. You have your 15% risk. Here's your cities and states at risk for the severe weather for Monday. And you also can see as it moves into Tuesday, day 5, the severe risk will decrease. Now, just like I told you yesterday, you can see as you go for the full 10 days, maybe something very weak forming in the Gulf. GFS takes it a little closer toward shore, but literally you have nothing happening for the next 10 days. And after that, showing everything is still going to be going into the Atlantic. We still got to watch out for the East Coast. Maybe, you know, a lee could be forming up, or maybe a last minute formation into the Gulf. It's just all these waters over here off the coast of Africa are just a little below average and cooler, and is stopping these southern storms from forming. So if it does form, it will be late formation or be coming off the coast northern, and it'll be going into the Atlantic. And you literally can see the latest updates. You can see with GFS, nothing forming because of all that information. I'll show you again. And once again, here we go. Last few frames, something popping up on GFS. And you see those ones that popped up yesterday are gone. If you go by the latest update, even that one is gone. You can even see this with the control member of the ensembles of the Ural that also goes 360 hours, just like GFS. And you can see nothing showing up for this one neither. Literally going through a quiet spell. And you can see right here, when you look at your sea surface temperatures, that you're just 2 below average. You see right here on the southern side of Africa that it's just below average temperatures right now on what's happening with these sea surface temperatures. So when the storms come off on the southern side, it's just too cooler of waters when it darts or starts upwelling for it to really come off strong and maybe late formation afterwards. If it comes off northern, it has a dry air in the dust and it's going to swing to the north. That's just a pattern that we are in. But changes are going to happen soon because all the precipitation that's way down here is going to start rising up. Then these waves will come off the coast of Africa, get more precipitation, and it'll start strengthening as it comes across. Now you can see this when you look at your GOES satellite for the dust. So when you look at the dust, you can also see not just the dry air, but you can see where all the precipitation is. So as these storms come off the coast of Africa, they're not really getting that, and it's cooler waters. But soon, look how all that starts raising up, and it gets thicker. So these waves are going to start getting stronger after we go into September. Starting sometime around September 6th through the 10th will be the beginning of it. So let's go through the latest updates so you can see what's going on with our potential velocity anomaly. And once again, you can see Central America is right below the Gulf of Mexico. And you can see right to the east of it is going to be in the Western Caribbean and going through by Florida, just so you can see where these areas are. Now, as we take a look at the potential velocity anomaly, you can see where these storms could form up. So let's start with the short range, then we'll start with what's after that. So keep your mind on that area. You can see where our area is that we look for any kind of development. And you can see clearly from GFS and Ural on the short range, as you go all the way to the very beginning of September, around the 6th or 7th, unfavorable environment moving through. That's with the Euro. But you can also see this on the GFS. All the way to September 6th or 7th, unfavorable environment. And as we take a look at the long range with the Euro, we see the same thing. All the way to September 6th, we have unfavorable environment moving through for our region. So you can clearly see that moving through right there. But you can see right after that, we have something forming up right into our Gulf. We have another one forming up sometime around the high teens, potentially, into our Gulf and the Caribbean. And after that, either the Western Gulf or the Eastern Pacific on that one. But look at this. As we go from September into October, look at that. That's a monster of a storm potentially forming right there. This is just like Ian when I showed y'all over a month early on Ian. We watched this come closer and closer and closer until it actually showed up. I will keep you updated. So far, of course, for the next 7 days, there's nothing with the National Hurricane Center. Still, maybe that sneaky wave might get a little area with a low chance for it to form, possibly. Other than that, there's not going to be anything going on for at least the next 10 days. Well, once again, thank you so much for your time, everybody. That has been the latest update. Hopefully, if you've never been here before, I've earned you a subscription. Consider hitting that like button down below. Show other nice people just like yourself what this information is that's coming out and what's going on in our hurricane season. Thank you so much. And before you go on to your lovely weekend, a quick word from Apostle Paul. 2 Timothy, verse 4, 1 through 8. I charge thee, therefore, before God and the Lord Jesus Christ, who shall judge the quick and the dead at his appearing and his kingdom. Preach the word, be instant in season, out of season, reprove, rebuke, exhort with all longsuffering and doctrine. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lusts shall they heap to themselves teachers, having itching ears. And they shall turn away their ears from the truth, and shall be turned unto fables. But watch thou in all things, endure afflictions, do the work of an evangelist, make full proof of thy ministry. For I am now ready to be offered, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith. Henceforth, there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give me at that day. And not to me only, but unto all them also that love his appearing. Amen. Hope you all have a great day. Remember, all glory does go to God our Father, Yahweh, in heaven. And I hope he always keeps you safe every single day of your life and your families, everyone around you and that you touch. In Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Even so, Lord, come. I will see you all on Sunday morning.